Hey, what's up, you guys? We're here over at Arbor's Pro Gym getting ready to do some chest. Right now, we're 3.5 weeks out from the 2013 Mr. Olympia contest. Weight right now is hovering just under 265. I was about 263 earlier today after my third meal, so it's not bad. Cardio has still been that twice a day, 45 minutes in the morning, 30 to 35 minutes at night. Been changing up different types of cardio, whether it be the bike or the step mill, various types of cardio this time. Right now, I'm going to walk you through a chest routine that I've been doing predominantly most of the second half of this part of the year, primarily because I felt like it's given me a little bit of a change. I know a lot of you guys have seen me do chest, you know, many, many times. So some of these exercises are going to be something that you are accustomed to seeing me do. But what we're really trying to focus on is making sure that we hit all the angles correctly, but more importantly, getting, you know, the constant tension and good contraction of movements. Sometimes I think we, you know, get so excited with, you know, just wanting to lift up that weight that we're moving around a little bit too much on the bench or, you know, on the flies, and everything else is moving instead of staying stable and staying focused and then just moving the chest, you know, the way it's properly done. So that's what I'm going to try to show you guys. Strength is actually still feeling pretty good, but we're going to find out today. So let's get started. Chest, but instead of going direct to the flies, which I'm usually noted to do, I wanted to use the strength that I had because I felt really strong on those presses to try to see what I could do on dumbbells today too. So, ready? Dumbbells over barbells, because I've noticed with barbells, I have a tendency to get shoulder injuries. The debate will always go on as far as what's better, but that's why you try it for yourself. 3 chest workouts left. And that's something that I want you guys to think about. Like, when you guys talk about doing 12-week preps, 16-week prep, you only have 16 workouts per body part, unless if you want to train them twice a week. So you only have 16 opportunities. If you go by a 52-week calendar, you only have 50 opportunities. 50, that's it. Throughout the year to make them count. I'm not just throwing stuff up there. I'm actually getting something out of it. I'm getting those improvements. And, you know, I've been pro since 05. I've been bodybuilding since October 2002, and people have been able to see the growth every year because, you know, the paying attention to the details and making sure that we leave the ego at the door. Then after that, we did some supersets, the cable crossover, this bad boy right here, and working the outer and the inner part of the pectoral. And that cable crossover was still skate because we all like to hit most musculars, you know, don't even matter if you're a bodybuilder or not. Pretty much every athlete hits the most muscular at some point. NBA guy dunks on a dude, hits the most muscular. Guy socks a guy, hits the most muscular. Boxing, MMA, all that stuff. So he definitely has some influence. Back and forth. We're going to do 5 sets of these, 10 reps of these, and we're trying to keep it about 90 seconds. Try not to get too many reps in here. I've never been this strong in these obstacle contests. And I think that's because I had a good productive offseason, even while I was traveling. Traveled over 120,000 miles before I even started this prep. So do all that and to be able to still have enough energy for this prep, I give myself a pat on the back. But, so that concludes our 2013 3-week out chest training routine. Pretty gassed right now, I can't lie. But definitely feeling like I got something productive. Hopefully you guys found it productive in your training. And you know, right now I'm just gonna go get something to eat. I'm starving. The number 13, no 14 coming, no need. You already got 13. See ya.